This is a free audiobook animation for Save the Reef, Book 10 in the Save the Earth series, written and illustrated by Bethany Stahl. Get your copy anywhere books are sold. You can learn more on BethanyStahl.com. I hope you enjoy this story. On a bright, sunny day, Grandpa and Liam jumped into the ocean to meet with Liam's friends. Kalisha, a mermaid, and Frank, a shark, were waiting for them to arrive.
"Ready to check on the reef?" Kalisha asked.
"Yes, I love sea plants!"
Liam smiled as he and Grandpa slipped on their scuba gear.
"Plants?"
Kalisha giggled. "Coral aren't plants. They are a colony of animals."
"But then where is their face?"
Liam asked.
"Not all animals have faces. Think about jellyfish," Kalisha said.
Agwe, a sea turtle, popped out of the water.
"Did someone say jellies?"
Giggling, the friends dove under the surface with Grandpa. Liam's eyes sparkled with wonder. Coral of all shapes, sizes, and colors fluttered softly in the current. The reef was full of life.
"It looks healthy today," Frank said thankfully.
But as the friends turned the corner, they gasped. This part of the reef no longer had beautiful colors, and there was not a single fish in sight. Instead, the coral was a pale skeleton of what it used to be. Liam looked at Kalisha with worry in his eyes.
"This is called coral bleaching." Kalisha frowned. "It happens when the ocean gets too warm. The coral gets sick, and when it does, it loses its color."
"It's like when people get fevers. They get warm and don't feel very well,"
Agwe explained. The friends swam to the surface.
"Can we help the coral?" Liam asked.
"We can try to help reduce greenhouse gases. They are gases in Earth's atmosphere that trap heat, like carbon dioxide. Renewable energy can help reduce greenhouse gases," Grandpa explained.
"And we can also reduce the energy we use by shutting off lights when we aren't using them,"
Liam chimed in.
"That would be great! When the Earth's temperature rises, the sea absorbs the heat, so reducing the gases that trap heat will help the ocean cool down," Kalisha said.
"What if we recycle and clean up the oceans?"
Agwe wondered.
"Yes, reducing pollution will keep the coral from getting too stressed,"
Frank agreed.
"And we can wear reef-friendly sunscreen.
Even if we live far away from reefs, the water we use will eventually mix with water that leads to the ocean. Protecting the reef from harmful chemicals is important to protect them,"
Grandpa explained. The friends dove into the ocean one more time. They saw something strange. There was a bright purple coral that looked like it was glowing. The friends swam carefully around the coral, looking at the color.
"Wow, I've never seen this before," Kalisha said.
"This coral is making a protective layer, like sunscreen, to protect itself while it heals."
"So coral reefs can come back from bleaching?" Frank asked.
"Yes! If we can work together to help the Earth, the coral can begin to recover," Kalisha smiled. We can save the reef!
Don't forget to grab your copy and check out all the other books in the Save the Earth series next. Thanks for watching!